everybody. I picked up a set of wooden stacking rocks from Amazon, and they came in one day, which was awesome. Some are a more raw wood, so a light sanding, but no stain. And then others have a more slippery acrylic finish. It's kind of glossy. Light sage and a cornflower blue, a baby pink. That one's much more hollow than I would have thought, like very light. A mint green, white. Hiding under here is a little peachy orange, and one bright. When it's kind of like a neon red. I just love that. So pretty. So, let's get some of these out. So the surface I'm on to play. I feel like these are going to fall. Might have to have some grass down here to muffle the sound a little bit. Shedding, and I got all over the carpet in the living room today, so I figured why not just brush him? That's why he's fussing. Why not just brush him and make a total mess and then sweep it up? And he hates the vacuum, so that's where the fussing is coming from. He's announcing that he's back up with the world. So if these fall, I hope that this cushions the sound a little. So as I moved you, they decided I'll fall down. Whatever. That's okay. I just love how these look like little eggs in a nest. I think that's so cute. Get away with that. Ready for the change of season wherever you are. Where I live in the northern hemisphere, we're going from spring into summer. So, for my southern hemisphere friends, would that be fall into winter? I watch D-E-E-Z, if I can say that, Desire ASMR, and she lives in Australia, and so I kind of mark the southern hemisphere seasons off of her food hauls. I love to watch her grocery hauls. I just think it's crummy that, you know, the calendars and things show holidays with certain months, but then they don't match the seasons in the southern hemisphere. I feel bad that it's so northern hemisphere centric. I've never been to the southern. Down they go. I've never been. Know in the comment section if you've ever been to your opposite hemisphere that you live in, or where you would love to go. I would love to go to Scotland and Italy and South Korea. Where else? My sister would like to go to New Zealand. I think Australia would be really cool. Where else would I like to go? So, as you can tell, my skin that's so white it's blue. My ancestors are from England, Scotland, and Ireland, so those three would be really nice to go where my namesakes come from. So that'd be very cool. Where else? had plans to go to Canada. Spring break of 2020. That did not happen. It did not happen. A place I love is Las Vegas. But I don't Las Vegas the way that you would see on TV or in a movie. I do a very chilled out, like Lady in a Moo-Moo version of Las Vegas, where it's all about sleeping in, hitting the pool, sightseeing a little bit, and then picking a fabulous restaurant or buffet. I'm gonna knock some of these over. I apologize if you don't like that sound. Oh. So you can hear them hitting the floor. First time I went, which is the only time I went, I don't know why I say first, I guess because I just want to go back. The first time I went, I didn't see a show, and I would love to see a show. But yeah, I don't gamble. I don't partake of the fun alcohol. Too many members of my family who are addicted, and it's just not worth to even start. So yeah, I do a super, super low-key Vegas. I hear there's a neon sign museum that I think would be really cool to check out. I'd like to see that. I always used to want to go to Washington, D.C., and then I heard that it's just way more spread out than you think, and that it's just walking and walking and walking and walking. So I don't know. I don't know if I could do it justice, or if I would, you know, putter out. To know where you want to travel or where you've been. What I really love is someplace you've been that you loved enough that you can't wait to go back, because that's a real destination right there. I don't think there. Oh, there are more. There are four more in there I couldn't see. This blue reminds me of my mom's decor in the late 80s, early 90s. Like everything was this dusty blue. I watch a channel on TikTok about naming design. Oops, sorry, I bumped you. I was trying to catch this little guy, but I just bumped you. About naming different types of design. And I don't remember what the gal called it officially, but you might know what I mean. It's like duck. Literally quack quack duck, pink and blue, 90s decor, and I knew exactly what she was talking about. My grandma and mom loved anything with a little scallop border, anything with lace, anything with a little calico print, and everything was pink or blue, and not baby pink or blue, like literally this kind of acrylic paint pink and this blue, and honestly a little bit of this sage too. Nothing was green. It was very pale sage, almost to blue. And things had little hearts and little gooses on everything. I don't know like how that even got started. I don't know if it's because there are Amish populations not that far from where we are, so it was kind of like this little cutesy take on country life. I don't know, but it just cracks me up. Well, geospatial has never been my gift. But hopefully, there's some good sounds in here. You are. I hope that you are happy.